Every child is precious. And in order to have equality amongst all children, it doesn't mean treating them all the same. It means giving them the means and support so that they can all be the same. And that's what we need. We don't need rhetoric. We have 11 separate demonstrations happening around the country. We kicked off this morning at 10:30 in Clare in Ennis, and they had over 100 people just in Ennis alone. In Limerick, they had a protest earlier on. They had over 300 people, and we're just waiting reports back from other areas around the country.
I'm here very simply because my son, Mark, who's 7, is just about, he's Down syndrome, and he's just about to lose his SNA. His resource hours have been cut back. This last straw.
I'm a teacher in a school for children who have special needs. We're not getting any direct cuts, but I am absolutely incensed by the cuts that have happened over the last number of years. And this is to add insult to injury at a time when we realise what happened with the banking fiasco.
They definitely fear disability protests. They definitely fear the power of families when we work together. They definitely fear organisations like ourselves, Down Syndrome, Irish Autism Action, Special Needs Parents Association. The list goes on. They definitely fear when we work together. And that has to be our sole aim, to work together. We're all here for one reason, and that's our children. And that's the children that SNA support. And that's the children, the teachers who come here today off their own back, try and teach. And we understand that there's difficulties in them trying to teach when they have a lack of resources in their own classroom and where they can't cope because they don't have the proper educational supports to help them actually teach our children.
I have a son with ADHD, and he had a special needs assistant in primary school, and he came on leaps and bounds, and I see the difference that an SNA makes to a child, and I'd like that for all the children who have special needs. And it's very important that these children get, not even just special needs assistance, they could do it occupational therapy, resource hours, speech and language therapy in schools, but the bare minimum we're being offered is only special needs assistance.
Shame on you! Shame on you! Shame on you!
See how Martin came out here to get his photo off. Among us, the people that he part of government that caused this problem, and he came out here to stand with us today as if he was going to do something about this.
Fianna Fáil, never again! Fianna Fáil, never again! Fianna Fáil, never again! Fianna Fáil, never again!
Since last Wednesday, Impact's phones have been inundated, emails to us to state very clearly that people have lost hours. As of from this Friday, there'll be numbers of SNAs with huge amount of skills that have lost their jobs. There'll be people going back on half hours, on 8 hours, and 3 hours in some cases. This is not good enough. There may be the same numbers, but there's not the same allocation.
And I'm here to support my grandson, Dara, who starts school in September. He has autism, and I would like to make sure that he has a good future.
The words access to an SNA have been shredded of any meaning by our politicians who slavishly make our most vulnerable pay while bailing out the bankers and the casino capitalists. The arrogance and the contempt of the Anglo boys and others. Billions here, billions there, never to be repaid, willingly handed over by the state and the political elite, who now steal the futures of our most needy children.
The danger of setting off parents against parents and schools against schools, where you're competing for resources, where parents with children who have not got a disability and parents with children with disability feeling that their children are going to be worse off. That's what's going to be the legacy of this government, that divisive, corrosive impact on society and the collectiveness of parents and schools together. We are a community, we have to stay together as a community.
We're putting bags on the railing because we wanted to represent that it's a child, it's a school bag, that it's not a number, that our children matter, and that's the reason why we want to put it on.
The only way that we will continue this protest is by sticking together.